Is a player with the WNBA. She was part of the United States under 17 team who won the 2013 FIBA Americas under 16 championship and subsequent 2014 FIBA under 17 world championship. And she's with me right now.
Hi. I'm good. How are you?
I'm really good. I'm so glad you're here with us today. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about your journey with making your mental health struggles public. You have been very open about mental health awareness. What was the sort of catalyst for you to start talking about your mental health in a public sphere?
Yeah, so it took me a little while to, feel even like I wanted to share that, and it kind of took me, seeing everything that's going on with this situation and pandemic we're going through right now, and seeing how there's so many people that are going through it out openly, but there's tons of people who are going through it privately and don't know that others are struggling just as they are. And so for me, I was able to speak on a panel just about, strategies to keep myself busy and not go stir crazy this time. It kind of gave me that opportunity and feeling like I did want to share, that people all over, all around go through this and go through different journeys with their mental health. And I kind of just wanted to share that with people.
That's so great. Being such an accomplished athlete, I think people might have like perceptions of you and your teammates and your ability to achieve. What do you think are some misconceptions that people might have about professional athletes, college athletes, and how you handle pressure? And what are your hopes to sort of, debunk some of the maybe more harmful myths that might exist around athletics and mental health?
Yeah, I think a big thing is, people only see what athletes do in their respective sport, on the field, on the court, whatever you play, and they kind of just see the outcome of the score, whatever you're doing on the court. And so, when you see that, you don't even think about the other side of when they go home. You think, oh, that's an athlete, they're professional, they're hardworking, they're used to all this pressure, they go, 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 go. And at the end of the day, everyone goes home and has their own experiences and struggles that they go through. And for me, I think, a big thing is like talking about mental health because there's such a stigma around it. Like you can still be an accomplished athlete, you can still perform at the highest level, you can still be, mentally tough in the hardest situations and have problems and go through things. It's not uncommon for athletes of all levels to go through different struggles on their own.
Yeah, that sounds very resonant and true. Do you feel like, being an athlete and being in a world that's sort of rarefied, that it's sometimes hard to connect with other peers who are, quote unquote, living more like normal lives or who aren't in this very rarefied sphere? And what are some things you do to sort of help build some community around yourself?
I think that's something I struggled to do a lot actually growing up. I think I was so, focused on my sport and I need to be as good as I possibly can at that, that I kind of neglected finding something outside of sports that I was passionate about, something that I could separate, being on the court and being at home and doing something I enjoy. It was kind of always just athletics, basketball, trying to be the best when 24 hours a day, you can't do that to yourself. And so, I think people need to find different things that they love to do. And for me, I've been able to build a community around me of friends and people that, I grew up with or my siblings and stuff to keep around me at all times to kind of get away from that athlete life at sometimes.
So, like finding a little bit of a life work balance, it sounds like, is something you've had to cultivate.
Yeah, absolutely. Because a lot of athletes don't look at their sport as work. I love playing basketball. It's something I do every day. But when it comes down to it, it's not, can't consume my whole life or else it'll drive me crazy.
Yeah, I could see how that would be the case. What are some things that you've sort of figured out over the years in terms of safeguarding your mental health? What are some coping strategies that you rely on to get you through challenging times?
I think the biggest thing for me, I actually you know, it took me a while to figure out that I was going through, you know, a lot of anxiety, a lot of issues with trying to eventually got help for. But at the time, I figured out that, you know, doing puzzles was something that worked for me, that I could kind of get my mind away from stuff like that. And so for me, it's kind of relaxing activities, because I feel like with basketball and with my sports, I'm always high energy, high adrenaline, trying to be up and going at all times. So when I can just like wind down, read, do a puzzle, listen to music, it helps me a lot.
You mentioned anxiety, and for our audience who's watching, for people who might feel like they're struggling with anxiety but might not even be sure if that's what it is, how did it show up for you? How did you kind of come to the awareness that what you were experiencing was in fact anxiety, and that it was something that you could fix or change or work on or develop coping strategies for?
Yeah, it wasn't for me. It wasn't until I kind of talked to someone and told them what I had been going through. I kind of hit a moment where, you know, just small inconveniences would happen and I couldn't control my reactions emotionally to them. And for me, that was something that I was like, I need to talk to someone about this. I need to figure out how to fix this. And so being able to talk to them and kind of just acknowledging that it was happening helped me a lot. And I think that's part of the biggest battle, is you deny, you don't want to talk about it. You don't want to accept that you have things going on that you need help with. And so once I was able to just kind of release that and tell someone about it and see what they had to say professionally, it took this huge weight off my chest.
Well, we're going to wrap up in just a minute here. I just want to know what you would like to say, if anything, to our audience right now who's watching. Is there any special message you'd like to share?
Just the biggest thing is knowing it's okay not to be okay. There's so many amazing people that have been talking on this today. So many people that we all go through something similar. It's all different. We all have our different journeys, but we're all connected.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
Thanks.